My buddy Gary said he just seen the doe sprinting towards a field, so maybe there's a buck chasing them or something. Hopefully they come my way. So it's crazy because there's not a lot of movement right now. It's November 8th, and that's crazy for the rut. I just had a freaking nice acorn come in. I wasn't ready for him to come in. And I tried grabbing my bow and waited there for him to grab. I had my bow in my hand getting ready. And he freaking spooked. So, it didn't spook hard, so it's good. I think this freaking squirrel started chirping and that fucking buck started getting weary. So, yeah, I didn't expect him to come. Like, it just kind of surprised me and I wasn't ready, so now I'm going to be ready. Alright, guys, that's a little update. Stay tuned. Well, guys, I might wrap up today's hunt. It's kind of frustrating when he had five opportunities to kill a buck and should have been tagged out by now, but you have to learn, I guess. Making dumb mistakes, but yeah, so hopefully we can get it done this week or next week, but you live and learn. That's what this channel is all about, living and learning, teaching other people what not to do and what you can do to become a better hunter. That's just part of bow hunting and hunting in general. Make mistakes, you learn from the mistakes and be better. So hope you guys enjoyed this video. Not a whole lot of action. I didn't even get to record that last buck I seen because he came in so hot. Like he was cruising down here and stopped about 23 yards as soon as I grabbed my bow and tried getting up and tried shooting at him, and he just spooked off. So, well, it didn't help that there's a freaking squirrel that spooked him too. Squirrel started chirping and he got weary and ran off. So, not a whole lot you can do about those kind of things. So, you win and lose, I guess. That's part of bow hunting. And you live and learn, like I said. So, stay tuned for the next video.